threats, and a threat there to cut off the nose of the lead actor in the film. Overstepping bounds of legality here completely, do you believe that state police should now step into action, that this is completely legally unacceptable?
According to me, this entire controversy about a film is completely unwarranted. It's completely illegal. Everybody has a right of freedom of speech and expression within certain bounds. If somebody makes a film, isn't it obvious that the film will have some fact and some fiction? That is how a film is made. It is made for entertainment of people. I mean, it is not grossly indecent, or it is not propagating sedition against the country. So if people want to see the film, they should go and see the film. If they don't want to see the film, they shouldn't go and see the film. Why shouldn't a film be allowed unless, as I said, you know, it transcends all borders of decency or sedition, or is not pornographic, etc., etc.
Mr. Rohatgi, as former Attorney General, we know that the Supreme Court has made some observations as well. In the case of Padmavati specifically, the Supreme Court referred the matter back to the CBFC, saying the Board of Certification will decide whether or not a film can be screened. So the Supreme Court is making it clear here that there is a process in place and that process needs to be followed.
There is no doubt that there is a process, but please understand that these issues on films being challenged by different sections on perceived notions of being hurt or talking about hurt to the community has been going on at least for the last 30, 40 years. I myself have done a large number of these cases. One of the cases I remember was also Mangal Pandey. Now, if you see historically what Mangal Pandey issue was and how it was made in a film, you know, is different, and it is bound to be different. There is nothing wrong in that. So the Supreme Court has referred it back to the board. The board will decide, but I must say the board will do well to keep in view that a filmmaker has a fundamental right to make a film, subject of course to the fact that he does not propagate pornography, does not propagate sedition, or does not propagate very, very indecent stuff which may hurt the community at large, etc. I mean, if those are the parameters, then unless this particular film, I have not seen, violates these kind of parameters, the film should be allowed.
Mr. Rohatgi, do you believe that state governments here or state police here need to step into action and take action against those publicly issuing death threats to the filmmaker and his cast?
I think it is very unfortunate that people get so incensed about things like movies, which are merely meant to provide amusement and pleasure. It is the job of the state government and its administration and the police to ensure that such films or other films are entitled to be screened, and people enjoy if they want to. If they don't want to go, they shouldn't go. But it is the job of the police to see that law and order is maintained even when films are screened, like anything else.